Friends, welcome to Center for Online Education. As dealing with the topic of production management, today we are going to explore another important topic that is known as the facility location planning. Facility location is derived from a word that is known as the location. So facility, the location at the place which you are going to give that facility, and it's all about the planning system. So you have to plan that at what location you have to provide what type of facilities. So as a production manager, it is one of the most important vital duty of a production manager to provide and to access the location at which he is going to provide the facility. Let's explore. What is location? Location can be defined as a place to put something. Okay? A place to put something means, as a production manager, you must have a proper knowledge, you must have a wisdom that you must properly define that what is the place, suitable place for application of the tools, machines, raw materials, and the plant layout. So here, location is very important. Now, what is facility? Facility location means a place to put the facility. Means facility and providing that facility at a specific facility is known as the facility location. Now, operating strategies for multiple facilities. Now, as a manager, if you are a production manager, there are four types of strategies which you have got as per the books of production management. These four types of strategy is being specialized for the specific areas. And if you are going to study all these four strategies, you must know that for plant system, production system, you have got different strategy. For market system, you have got different strategy. The processing system means the moving of a product from one plant to another plant, from one machine to another machine, you have got different strategy. And you have got a general strategy also, where it is a mix of all the above three mentioned strategies. As you know, that the strategy is a word which is being derived from the French word that is known as a stratagia. Means you are preparing for the war which is not being there, but all the things you have to plan. In the modern world, in the competitive world, there is no war as such. But as per of our competitors, we have to make our strategies so that our product fits in the market in a better manner, in a better position rather than our competitors. So there are the four strategies which is being given in the books of production management. First is the product plant strategy. Second one is the market area plant strategy. Third one is the process plant strategy. Fourth one, the last one, is general purpose plant strategy. So all these strategies are well defined, and on the specific specialization, you have to apply these strategies. Now let's explore one by one each strategy. The first one is product plant strategy. As by the name itself says that, it is a strategy applied by a production manager when he is going to see that he is placing the product and the plant in the nucleus. Means all the strategies he is going to frame, he has to put his product and the plant at where the product is being manufactured in the nucleus. So product or product lines are produced in separate plant, and each plant is usually responsible for supplying the entire domestic market. So here, the product or the line of the product means the chain in which the raw material has been completed into this final product. It separates each thing, and each plant is responsible to fulfill the demand of that specific area. It is decentralized approach, as each plant focuses on a narrow set of requirement that includes specialization of labor, materials, and equipment along the product line. Here, there is a disorganization of the process. Here you required specialized workers, machines, equipments. Why? Because here each plant is producing and supplying in the local market. So whenever a production manager has to work on the area of decentralization, means one plant is being set up at South India, one in the North India, both are going to produce the product, but the company, the plant which is being in the South India are going to produce and supply in the South Indian market only, and the company of the plant which is being set up in the North India are going to produce the product and supply in the North India only. So this is a strategy which is being very helpful. Now, what is the specialized function of the plant product strategy? Specialization involved in this strategy usually result in economics of scales and compared to multi-purpose plant, lower operating cost. As you all know that the operating cost reduces over here because the product is being produced as per the need or the demand in the market. So, somewhere or the other, the economic scale is being properly observed and followed over here, and on the basis of that, we are going to make our strategy. The plant location may either be widely scattered or placed little close to one another. Means, as a production manager, in this strategy, you have to see that you have to get into the climatic condition of that specific country. And it may be that the plant is being scattered all over the country or in a composite place. It depends upon the availability of the raw material and the cost of production. And it also depends upon the specialized worker. For example, if you are working into some specific area where you have got less specialized worker, so it is very difficult for a production manager to apply and set a plant over there. For setting a plant, you have studied that in plant location, the availability of a specialized worker must be there, because it's all about the worker who are going to help, whether it is operation of the machines or putting the raw material into machines or following the specific chains. Packaging, everything should be done by the worker. So chief worker, wherever you are going to get the worker who are going to work on a chief basis, you are going to apply this strategy. Now this next one is the market area plant strategy. By word itself says that it is a strategy where market is being kept into nucleus. In the first one, product and plant is being kept into nucleus. So market area, we used to see that where is the market in which we are going to produce our product and sell our product. And we used to put our plant closer to that area where we are going to get the market. Here plants are designed to serve a particular geographic segment of a market. Means geographic segment of a market says that you know that where is a demand, and according to that demand you are going to produce your product and supply it to the market for the consumer and the customer to buy it. The individual plant can produce either most or all of the company's products and supply a limited geographical area. Means here what is done is that a product is being manufactured and it is being seen that it is being sold over that specific area. We are not going to target about the globalized area. We are targeting the specific geographical area. The operating cost of this strategy are oftentimes higher than those of products plant, but saving of shipping cost for a comparable product can be made. As you all know that for each and every market you have to make or you have to set up a different plant. So the cost of setting up a plant increases the cost, overall cost. But sometimes the cost of shipping is more than the setting of a plant. So whenever this conditions come over here, prevail over here, means the transportation cost is very high, you are going to set the plant over there and you are going to produce for the local market. So this is the things on which planned market ADA strategy works. This strategy is useful when shipping costs are high due to volume, weight or the other factors. As I have told you that the shipping cost is very high. Why? Because it might be the product is very heavy or the product is somewhere where there it is a difficult to take the product from one place to another place. So this strategy is being followed. It can also bring the added benefits of faster delivery and response time to the local needs. Whatever changes in the technology can be there, you have to take into consideration and you change according to the product. You implement that technology in the product and you upgrade your product. So market area strategy is somewhere very important because it's added and makes the delivery system faster and quicker for the customers. It requires a centralized coordination of decisions to add or delete plant or to expand or downsize current plant because of changing market conditions. If you are following market area strategy, you can downsize the plant, means you can close a plant or you can increase the plant capacity. You can see that according to your demand, you have to supply your product. If your demand is high, you have to take and bring more machines into consideration. And if the demand falls, you have to downsize your current plant system. So market area strategy is being followed when a manager used to keep market in the nucleus while framing the strategy. Process plant strategy. Again, here the process of a production unit is being taken into consideration. Means from where you are going to get your raw material, processing that raw material into final product. So this process is being considered over here. So when you are going to consider the process, this strategy is going to be followed. Here, different plant concentrates on different aspects of a process. Means some product requires different plant A, B, C, D. And on the basis of these, their product is going to outcome. For example, you are going to manufacture a cold drink. So a plant, in a plant, you require to make a bottle. In a plant, you require to make the cap of the bottle. In a plant, you require to make the labels which you are going to put in the advertisement that you are going to put on the bottle. In a market, you are going to make the product which is going to be filled in the bottle and being sold in the market. So here, in this strategy, all the process has been considered because you have to make the product. You have to make the packet on which the product is going to be sold and also the labeling which is being there. So all these things require three machines and it is a process. It is a process in which A, B, C comes into according to the process in which the final product is going to come out. This strategy is the most useful when products have numerous components. Separating the production of components result in less confusion than if all the production were done in the same location, as I have taken the example. So bottle should be made first, then you must also have cap. This must be taken into unit C, where the liquid is being made and filled in the bottle. Then the cap is being put over there. Then in the fourth unit it will go and the labeling will be done. And after that labeling, proper sealing will be done. So you require five machines of the five plant. So here, there is a system, there is a process which is to be followed. And as you have got different system, different plant, there is a lack of confusion. Why? There will be no confusion, as you all know that this plant has got this specialized work and he is going to carry that. So an order, a process, a system is being made and according to that process, order or system, the work is being done. Now, a major issue with this strategy is the coordination of production throughout the system and it requires a highly informed centralized administration in order to be an effective operation. As I have taken the example over here, For example, you have made a lot of product which is being filled in the water, but you don't have got the enough bottles, or you have got enough bottles, you have also got the material which is being filled in the bottle, but you don't have got the cap, or you have got all three things, but you don't have got the labels which is being put in the bottle. So here, a proper coordination of the process must be required. How many liters of the things which you are going to produce, and that specific product requires how much bottle, and that specific bottle should be equal to the number of caps which is manufactured, and that too equalize with the number of labels which is being produced. So when this cycle is going to be there, automatically you have got a cost-effective operations. Now the next one is, it can bring about additional shipping cost, but a key benefit is that individual plant are highly specialized and generated volumes that brings to economics the skills. Automatically, if you are going to carry one product into different plant, you require a shipping cost. The cost of transportation increases. But as each and every plant is performing an specialized function, automatically the wastage reduces and the cost of product is being decreased. So the profit margin increases. So this is the third strategy we have discussed. Now the general purpose plant strategy. Plants are flexible and have the ability to handle a range of products. General purpose, as I have told you, it is a combination of all three strategy. Here, on the basis of the flexibility, the product, the market, and the nucleus, the product line, everyone should be taken over here, and according to that, we frame a general purpose strategy. It allows for a quick response to product and market changes, but can be less productive than a more focused approach. A benefit of this approach is the increase in learning opportunities that happens when the similar operations are being done in different plants. Solution to problems as well as the improvement made at one plant can be shared with the other plant. So here, whenever you have got a quick response system which you want, or whenever you want a specialized function, whenever you have to see that what are the improvements which you are going to made in your production management system or in your plant, you have to follow general purpose strategy. So general purpose strategy is important, where we are going to discuss with the flexibility of the product and the flexibility in the demand approach. Now, what are the factors affecting facility? The first one is customer proximity. Means, customer, what is the demand of the customer in that specific area? Whether whatever product you are making is being demanded by the customer or not, whether the customer is willing to buy your product or not. So somewhere or the other, the customer's satisfaction to your product is very important. So for providing proper facility location, you must have to consider the customer. Business area. Automatically, as a business unit, you are working for profit. You have to select an area where you are going to get the more and more and more profit, because each and every company wants to extract more and more profit from the market. So here, as a business manager, you have to take out the best area in which you are able to sold your product. Availability of skilled labor. As I have told you in the past also, the labor is very important for any production unit. So wherever you are going to get the best labor who have specialized in that specific area, while the cost of labor should also be less than the other areas in which you are. So you must have got a cheap labor over there. Means the cost of production should be reduced. Then free trade zone or agreements. There are certain zones made by the government in which you are going to put your plant and save your tax. the government used to facilitate that they are giving a facility of no tax system up to 5 years, 10 years. You have got free trade agreement between different companies, different countries, where you have got, there is no export or import rates, tax system. So here it is very important that a person should also consider this while facility locating. Then suppliers. Suppliers are most important for any production unit, because you are going to get your product and supply it to the market. Easily available suppliers reduces the cost of overall production. So for facility location, one must consider supplier also as an important factor. And the last one is environmental policy. What product you are making and whether it is conducive towards the environment or not. If it is beneficial for the environment, it is not harming the environment, you will get the proper license properly in an easy manner. But if you are making any product which is violating the law of environment, automatically that you are not going to get the license and more taxes will be levied on your product. So all these factors are very important whenever you are going to do the facility. The first one is the customer, then the area of the business, then the skilled labor, free zone, trade zone, free agreements, suppliers and environmental policies. So these factors are very important. So somewhere or other, we have discussed and explored all the four strategies. These four strategies are dependent on the specialized areas. The first one depends upon the product, while the other one depends upon the market. And the third one depends upon the product line, while the fourth one is a general strategy. So I have also explained the factors on which this facility is being dependent. So as a production manager, whenever you are going to do facility location, these factors are very important and these strategies are very helpful for you to take the proper decision. I hope you all have understood. Thank you.